When we're asked about the evolution of underwriting, I'm struck by the parallels that we see to clinical medicine. We're sure that healthcare and the way that healthcare is going to be delivered in the next 15 years or so is going to be markedly different, but nobody is exactly sure of what it's going to look like. We're seeing signs that these long talked about concepts around big data and predictive analytics and artificial intelligence are beginning to really influence fields such as genetics and cancer treatment and population health. So the first thing that's changed is the makeup of the team. It previously included actuaries and underwriters, and that's still the majority, but now it's a part of a much broader team that includes data scientists, behavioral scientists, information technology, as well as all those many disciplines that make up RGAX. Now we need to become familiar with and leverage a wide set of analytical tools. Now we need to be equally cognizant of potential impact on automated rules underwriting or automatic facultative acceptance programs, prescription scoring, or the interpretation of digital health data. The second thing that's changed is the needed skill set. Now we are faced with learning a wide set of pretty advanced analytic tools and learning how to leverage these tools as well. I think the journey is a perfect word to describe what we're doing here at RGA. It's not going to be a straightforward path, but it begins with a strong foundation of risk assessment tools. And we've got those, but these need to be constantly improved upon and iterated so that with each iteration, we get more precision and personalization. One thing that won't change is that facultative underwriting and appropriate risk classification will remain in the DNA of RGA. Doing the same job as our client carriers allows us to bring insights that are difficult to replicate when it comes down to how do we incorporate these tools into our evolving journey.